Guys, today I'm gonna show you how powerful Xeons are. This is a benchmark of one of the decent games, one of the best games of the year. This is the Corona Render benchmark. We will put two benchmarks on the same machine. This is the benchmark of Tomb Raider. This is the machine. Small with GTX 1070. There's a 14-core E5-2697v3. So we have two benchmarks running at the same time. So the game and the benchmark of Corona Render. They both can be running on the same machine because the Corona is using CPU extensively and the Tomb Raider is using GPU and also two cores of this CPU. So we have graphics of the high-end game. This is Full HD. This is not 4K. I don't know if 4K would be different. I think for 4K I would use two graphic cards like this, and it would be okay also, because the thing about the game is it doesn't need much more power of CPU, because it's always the same one game, it uses more GPU. Okay, so those are the scores. So as we can see, minimum was 8.525, so it, something happened. On Polish version I didn't have that, but 24 minimum on Syria, and we have 20 minimum on Valley. Okay, so now if we see maximum and if we see average is about 60 FPS, yes, overall score 55. This is the benchmark of Corona Render. Now, okay, this time Corona Render is faster than on the Polish version. On the Polish version we had 150. Okay, so this time Corona Render was faster, I don't know why, anyway. So, 145. So, two benchmarks at the same time, and I would say something like this. So let's see what this times mean, because maybe we should compare Corona Render to something. I don't know if how can we compare the benchmark of Tomb Raider. Anyway, so we will see like this. This is the benchmark of Corona. Best score in heavy overclocking for i7-6950X is better than 145, but there was no game running in the background. Okay, let's see. E5-E7-5960. Okay. 143 heavy overclocked, 4.68, no game running in the background, I'm sure. So my build is almost as fast as this one, because there's a lot of points like this. It's as fast when playing a game in the background. Okay, so we will see other very known CPUs. These are 6070K. Fastest score, 254. No game in the background running. 4970K. Maybe 4790. Seconds. Okay. Anyway, what I can say, this one is the fastest because those are my scores, and this is the fastest. This one is the fastest. E5-2697v3. Okay. Okay. This benchmark demands 64 gigabytes of RAM to be faster than in 1 billion of P. But anyway, in terms of overclocking, it's the fastest in Cinebench R15 and R11.5 for 14 cores, and also in Geekbench multi-core. So, anyway, we were starting to say to talk about can you play on Xeon? So I just showed you that I can play on Xeon while my benchmark is running of render in the background. Those are my points for global cups. Those are hardware cups. Okay, this is the first guy in Poland, 18 for global hardware, 55. This is the second guy in Poland, and they have more points than I because they are using much more let's say known equipment, so CPUs like i7s. I'm not using i7s, I'm using Xeons. So anyway, I would say that in terms of having a very powerful machine, you just cannot say that i7s are better for rendering. Overclocking is surely good at them, but this is not the point. And if we just, let's say, cancel, what we will see. Those are CPUs, all rendering CPUs are Xeons. Many of them, like 2697v4, will be a good point to have fun and play a game. Because if you see that those CPUs has very high high clock, then they are good for playing games. Because the games demands mostly 4 threads which are on high clock, that's all. And of course, if you will be able to grant them exclusive memory placement, it's all okay. So what I would like to show you one more thing. Sure that the i7 overclocked to almost 5.7 gigahertz had much higher temperature, because I think that this one had at least, if you see this one, this was heavily overclocked. So I think this one had about 70, 75 to 80 degrees. And that's all, folks. I think you should be able to understand how Xeons work, how they are very good. Thank you very much for your attention. If you have any questions or any comments, please write them down